we are, Faith Driven Outdoors. We got an exciting episode for you. We got two really exciting hunts. This first one's definitely fun. We actually walked into the stand that morning. We didn't plan on hunting there, but the train got us stuck, so we had to go a long way. Run in there. There's a pig asleep underneath the feeder. Big boar hog. I get up in the stand. He runs off. He comes back. The minute the feeder spins, he runs off. It ran off a little early, so we couldn't quite get a shot. He ran about 50 yards, or I thought it was about 45. So I shot underneath him, and I thought kind of the morning was over. Well, so I thought the morning was almost over. Let me know what you think, what happens next.
Decent smaller pigs and one big sow, and was able to get a good shot on her for sure. I'm pretty sure she's dead. I don't know, right there. Didn't get the deer hunt this morning with the train, but hey, we have an overpopulation of pigs. I tell you, eating food from God's creation is the best. And on a side note, I can't be more pleased with the Mission crossbow. Made a great shot. Pretty sure it looked like he hit behind the dot on the 42 yard shot on that pig. Not sure, that one ran right in the swamp, but this sow right here, I mean, if you see it hit right there, the black eagle ears did a phenomenal job. I'm sure the Rage broadheads did great because she didn't run about 50 yards that way. So couldn't thank that enough. Can't thank my Lord and Savior for just allowing me to come out here and hunt. That's the most important thing. There's no other way but that God did it. I can tell you, it's something special. Even when we don't shoot nothing, I enjoy helping other people find deer. I enjoy just sitting. It's just something about the peacefulness. No distractions. Just sitting in God's creation and just going, wow. And to think of all the stuff he made, and he still loved us. He loved me, he loved you. He was willing to send his son to die for us so that one day we could see him again and live in eternity with him. So I can tell you one thing. If you're watching this, either give me a call, I'll tell you, I'll open the Bible and show you what it means to be saved and how to be saved, or go to a local church and ask a preacher, or if you got a friend that goes to church, ask them. But if you're not sure, or something's tingling down inside going, oh, something, maybe he's talking to me, ask somebody. Eternity depends on it for you. Brian's tip of the week, what we're going to call it. So for you new hunters, they're just getting started, trying to figure out what to pack in your bag, what not to pack. A couple essentials. Always pack a good snack, and always pack something to drink. Some people take this too serious and sit up in the stand with nothing, and they're miserable. It's nothing like your stomach growling, your head hurting. It's Florida, it's usually hot, which thank the Lord has blessed us. It's like 62 degrees this morning in September. But again, this week's tip of the week, don't take it too serious. Have a good time, have fun, that's what you're out here for. Snack and a drink. That's Brian's tip of the week. Well, finally got on the blood trail once I got out of the water. She's bleeding pretty good. She ain't bleeding the best, but I'm pretty sure I heard a crash right over here too, so. One big old sow down.
Here we are, Fellowship Outdoors. God bless us with a big old sow. Probably 120, 130 pounds. Just a crazy cool morning, because you've seen earlier. Didn't get to go to the stand we wanted to, and then coming in here, the big boar hawk stood underneath the feeder and slept until the feeder went off, and it didn't go off. It was just daylight and it ran off about 50-ish. Feel like I made a good shot, looked good through the scope. I'm about to go look, see if I actually hit it. We'll check that arrow. I didn't run off very good, so I don't think I got it. We had a great shot on her. She didn't run. 30, 40 yards, blood everywhere. I couldn't be more happy with the Rage broadheads. Leave a good entrance hole, good exit hole. My missions, sub one, shoots great. Hit right behind the dot. So I want to thank my Lord and Savior most of all for giving me the opportunity to go to hunt with my dad, with my wife. That's the most important thing, is spending that quality time with each other, and getting to put meat in the freezer is always a very, very big bonus. So we'll see you next time, Fellowship Outdoors.
Well, as you can tell, an exciting morning. Pig hit the ground. We now have fresh pork chops and sausage in the freezer. So super excited. Couldn't thank my Lord and Savior definitely for the opportunity that day. And things didn't go as we thought they were going to go, and they still turned out great. And now we're back in the woods on a Sunday morning before church, and let's see what happens.
Stay tuned, we'll go get this pig, and we'll be right back.
The old Rage did a pretty good job. I mean, good blood. I mean, the definition of blood like a stuck pig. Pretty good sized pig. Pig on the ground.
Here we are, Fellowship Outdoors. Here's the pig. Good one. You've seen on a trail job, it bled great. Couldn't thank my Lord and Savior most of all for giving me the opportunity to come out here and hunt. A lot of people would dream to have the opportunity to come out in the woods and hunt. So thanks to him the most for just giving me that opportunity. The Black Eagle Raven arrows shot great, shot all the way through, blew through a shoulder blade, still nothing wrong with it. And of course, the Rage broadheads to me did a phenomenal job, blood everywhere. Drag it out, and we're going to come in here, throw him up, and get him clean. So stay tuned next time. Maybe next time we'll have a deer on the ground. See you on the way.
Well, another pig hit the ground. Other pork chops in the freezer. More sausage in the freezer. Again, I couldn't thank our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ enough. I know I say it all the time, but I always give him all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise for what he's done in my life, what he continues to do in my life, and even the opportunity to do this, something I dreamed of as a kid. All that goes to him. Thank my family. I want to thank y'all. I appreciate y'all's likes and your supports. So please like it. Please share it. Please subscribe. Please show us the support. If you have comments, let us know what you think. We
super appreciate it. Next week's episode, I get my first buck on footage. So it's super exciting. So the next episode should come out in a few weeks. Hope y'all enjoy that as well. Thank y'all again for everything, and hopefully we'll see you next time in the outdoors.